part four, catfish fingerlings production preparation. Now, this segment we're going to talk about feeds, right? Now, you see on the table all kinds of stuff like we're exporting to United States foodstuffs from Nigeria. No, these are materials that are going to be eaten by somebody's catfish. Now, we're going to start from the beginning. Now, like I said, if you have access to the book and the DVD, everything is stated in there. Two options. These are imported stuff, but the local ones are there, right inside the book. What do you need to do from day one to day 52? So let's get cracking quickly. Now, this first one is called Artemia salina. Now, Artemia salina is they are shrimps got from Utah Lake in the United States, you know, dried into cyst and then brought down all over the world. Now, people will have to simulate the environment in Utah Lake, which is about ambient sunlight using the heavy incandescent bulb, about 60 degrees centigrade or so, and then you make sure it's bubbling like the beach, and you make sure you put salt water. Now, all of it are stated right in the book, in this catfish fingerling production book. Now, let's see what page we have it here. Oh, guideline on branching hatching. Now, but people are getting lazy for one reason or the other, pardon me to use that word, because the effort of having to, not even that, because of constant electricity issue in Africa generally. So people don't hatch anymore. So manufacturers have gotten wise too. So they start and sell the ones that are hatched already. So this is already hatched. What they just do is scoop, open up, cut it, scoop, and give to your fish. The only challenge is that the waste will be there. And you know already, if you have any proteinous waste, this guy comes to your rescue once it's inside the water, because the proteinous waste will be converted to edible materials for your fish to eat. So with this, you are safe using this. Now, if you don't can't afford this, of course, in the village or thereabout, you can still use egg yolk. It's all detailed in the book, mind you. So you have that option. That is starting for fingerlings production. Then the next one, now you're going to do that, you know, day one, day two, day three, you're not going to feed your fish. But from day four, you're going to use either the egg yolk. From day four to almost day seven to day 10, you're going to use the Artemia. The alternative to the Artemia is this 0.1. This is heavy protein, imported. Alternative to the Artemia, if you can't find the Artemia, they've got the same component. Almost what percentage protein now in the Artemia? I think it's almost, let's see what we have on the shell here. Okay, 58%. Oh, that's the protein we have here. But fish needs about that until they progress to the fourth or fifth week. So, that's for that. Then, the moment the fish start getting older, you move on to the next one. Now, I'm not particular about any manufacturer, but what's important is 0.4 mm. And this cool protein is about 64%. The more protein you have, the better for you. I'm not saying use 100%, but that's why one of the best things you can ever do to your fish is to give him another fish to eat. After all, it's a cannibal. Man, dog eat dog, eh? Not man eat man, please. Oh. But carnivore eat carnivore, you know, we are herbivorous, or even tending to herbivorous stuff. So I think this will be okay. If you can grind fish, raw fish for your fish, oh, they'll be happiest ever. And by the way, you can ask me for a Nigerian alternative to all of this. Right. The name starts with an L. Grind it, full amino acid profile, and you can save costs and yet have your fish grow extremely big the local way. So this is 0.4. now you're going to use this for a few days, like it is on the table in the book here. Don't ask me how many days. I'm not giving an inaugural lecture here. So get the book, please, to have idea of the dates. There's so much to cover, right? So this is 0.4, and then spilling, then we have the 0.5 to 1. Now that's about 60% cool protein you see on the body. Fat is about 15%, right? Oh man, this is good for your fish, isn't it? Then after that, you move on to 0.9 to 1.6 mm, right? If you look at it, you still got the same 60%, but the size of the crumble is what matters. It's getting bigger now to fit into the mouth of the fish. That's what's important. And then from there, we move on to 1.3. If you look at, things are getting cheaper here now. 58% protein, 70% good fat. And you see, it's looking bigger now. Now, look like really unrefined garri that we're used to in Southwest Nigeria. Isn't it? So, this looks okay. And then from there, you graduate. Now, you're going past fingerling system now. Some sell their fish at that, where they can hit, take that crumble, at but they call it Ijebu or thereabout, and then post fingerlings or thereabout. Now, we can now move to the area of juveniles now. Now, we're talking about 2 mm. Now, if you want a fish that's perfect, you know, that won't give you hassle when you purchase, then you better go for a fish that can take 2 millimeters feed. Because that kind of fish, that cannibalism will be a little bit less, and brutality will be less. Why? It's got the energy to swim 1 meter up, 1 meter down. You will get more from the video on fingerlings production, what I mean by that. And then from there, your fish quickly moves to 3 mm. So all the samples are going to my Congolese friend. I just felt like to share all of this with you. Is that okay? Now, by the way, like I said earlier on, I'm going to talk about medications. You know, people have problems with their feeds, with their fish occasionally when they start producing under intense condition, out of greed, excitement, and the rest. You're not distributing them, or maybe out of apparent, naivety, or just because you are just a sophomore, you're just starting out, you know, ignorance. So there are a lot of medications out there that are meant to serve as prophylaxis. Let's look at one. I'm not trying to sell anybody here, but then what's important, if you look at this has a pyridoxine. That's what even special about this now that I want to talk about, because several times people tell me that their fish is looking whitish on the body. The body seems to be peeling. Now, one of the reasons why that happens, are you getting me, is because of the absence of folic acid and pyridoxine in the food. So just look for a medication that has that in the system. This does the job. Now you can see this has folic acid in the system. So when you see your fish showing whitishness, then what you do is just to mix this biotics with it straight away, and you are on. Why don't I want to show the name of the manufacturer, because people who sign on dating me, they want that particular brand. And when you go into the market, you see all kinds of stuff. So what you just look out for is the components. Any guy that has folic acid 5 milligrams, you know, guys, now they for those of you who are fathers now, when your wife got pregnant first time, what they say you should start looking around for folic acid, right? So as the baby can be formed appropriately, isn't it? So the same folic acid, but you don't use the one you give it to madame to give to the fish. This was our soul in sachet like this. And I think that's enough for us. Now, some people say their fish used to have cloudy eyes and they're all kind of... Now, for those with cloudy eyes, I think what they need is pyridoxine I just talked about. What I talked about now, pyridoxine. That's exactly what they need. A little bit of thiamine to offset and prevent, as if the fish had vitiligo. You know, vitiligo, when you look as if you have acid on your body or thereabout. So I'll just talk about these two. Now, I might come up with a book later on fish diseases to really help out in this area. But if your fish has any problem at all, and you're in Nigeria, I suggest take it to the diagnostic center. The most popular in Nigeria is the Animal Care Vet Services. It's gained grants a lot, and they're very reliable. A company run by the late Dr. Alberto, I think his son is taking over now, and they're doing great strides. So just take a few there for post-mortem or whatever it is, and then let me know the results. Then I can tell you what exactly to use, so you don't hold on until you use plenty of fish before you take action. Hope that's okay. Now, apart from those specific ones I talked about, you can always give your fish a prophylaxis. And what's a prophylaxis? A little bit of antibiotics, right? Like oxytetracycline and vitamins. You can see all the vitamins here. It's a fish I want to start in the alphabet. A, you know, D, K3, E, C, B2, B1, all of sorts, you know. And this is okay. You can add it to your feeds occasionally, you know, as prophylaxis to prevent them from having this. Just like use multivitamin too, especially to reduce stress so that you can withstand the pressure of malaria, typhoid, and even corona. won't mention that. But then, now it's the season of coronavirus. They got deliver us. So. Okay. So now this one looks interesting to me because it's got a large dose of vitamin C. Vitamin C is important because when the weather begins to get cold now, rainy season or overtime period, this is a must to have vitamin C to the diet so that the fish can have resistance to cold. Just like anything that has to do with respiratory ailments, you know, even for coronavirus, too, they say use a lot of vitamin C, isn't it? So I'm not saying your fish is going to have corona. It's you that should be careful. You can't pass it over to a fish. By the way, anybody with coronavirus infection can't even think of doing aquaculture in the first instance. It's all about survival you're thinking of. So what's important is that the fish is taking vitamin C to make his immune system top-notch. Having talked about all of this, you know what? If you don't want to go through all of this sachet, you want to reduce the amount you're using, then why not get them, make them have water that is top-notch, natural spring water. But make sure you install this between your light tank, pass through the plumbing system before going to your tank. Then the immune system of your fish comes out 147%. What do we call this? I mentioned it in part 3. It's called longitudinal electromagnetic device. Run on scalar energy. That's a topic for another day. If you want to know more about it, just call me. This is what top-notch, serious fingerling production unit farmers are using. A lot of them producing 300,000, 400,000. That's not to scare you. Start from 10,000 first. But know that you need this as you grow. And want to be stubborn in quotes, and want to grow quickly, then make sure you get this LED device. It's only sold by Mr. Fish for now. And then have access to the Fish Survival Booster. And I tell you, remember, Mr. Fish is your pastor. When the money comes in, remember my own offering.